Okay, you're about to be on stream.
All right.
And we're there.
All right, what's up, guys?
Countdown whenever you're in.
All right. Let's have Mario Man do the countdown.
Oh, okay. Man.
Waiting here on the file.
All right, let's do it on go.
On go?
Yeah. Alright, what's up? This is Yoshi's Island 100%. 100% includes getting a score of 100 at the end of all of the levels, which entails getting 30 stars, 20 red coins, and all 5 flowers. So it's a pretty cool run. Pretty cool run. I'm sure most of you have seen it before. Yep, so right at the beginning there, before I enter the first level, I switched my control scheme to use hasty eggs, and I'll let my boy Mario Man tell you what that's all about while I do this next segment.
Hasty is when you release, you can press the A button to start aiming an egg, and if you release it, the egg will instantly launch from Yoshi's arsenal of eggs. But when you have a normal control scheme on, you usually have to lock it in place first, and then like press it again to release.
Yeah. Alright, a little bit of 1-1 spaghetti, it's fine, it's pretty standard.
Turn Mario Man up!
Aye!
One thing that's interesting about the stars in this game that you see him getting, the 30 stars, if you get hit while you have more than 10, they don't recover. But when you get hit when you have less than 10, they regenerate up to 10. So, if he gets hit, he needs to find a way to recover quickly, so he can still end the level on 30 stars and get 100%.
That's right. So, alright, hopefully Mario Man's audio is good now. Someone will have to tell me. It might be way too loud.
Yeah. So, a cool little fact is that those title screens where you saw 1-2.
Turn up more? Alright, hold on, give me a sec.
Where you see 1-2, if you mash all the buttons on the controller, it helps speed it up and you can skip past it. This section right here, you normally turn into a helicopter, but you can just flutter and bounce on these guys, which is pretty cool. Get through it. I can explain some basic mechanics of the game. Let's start here with the Z-Wing skip. It's basically at the end of each level, you have this little rotating thing on the goal ring of flowers and dots, and if you land on a flower, you get a bonus game. But to not get a bonus game, you have to do a special trick, which involves Yoshi's speed. Normally, if you're traveling at top speed, you'll get a bonus game, so what you do is you download grab an enemy and spit it right before a the goal ring to slow Yoshi down just enough so you'll always skip it. Some levels have different methods to skip bonuses, such as this level 1-3 right here, which we'll see. I'll explain it at the end, but it's pretty interesting. Another mechanic you'll see is when Trix tongues an enemy, he doesn't slow down, and that's because if you stop tapping, if you don't hold down the direction that you're tonguing, when you eat an enemy, you don't slow down. So if you let go of the direction, tongue, and then repress it, you'll maintain full speed. It's pretty cool. It makes the game a lot more technical with movement. Same goes for spitting and such.
Yeah, when you do most actions in this game, you gotta let go forward, or it'll slow Yoshi down a ton. Alright, so probably not gonna be doing the bonus skip Mario Man was talking about here. I was actually found out that there's like a 1 in 3 chance that doesn't work, so I'm just gonna do a Z-Wing skip there. But yeah, basically, gold rings will always load in at the same spot, so if you run into them at full speed, they'll always land on the same dot on the ring. So unfortunately, that dot happens to be a bonus, so it would be really easy if you wanted to always get a bonus every level. But that's obviously not what we want to be doing. So there's every level we just have a different way of making sure Yoshi slows down a certain amount so that he doesn't get a bonus.
Yep.
So at the beginning of this level, I'm going to be back-tonguing some of these eggs. I just want to be at 6, which is the max number of eggs Yoshi can hold at any given moment. Here I'm going to do a little left-right to scroll the screen a specific way so these enemies will let me get an egg through them.
Oh man, that juggling.
Yeah.
So, you can do stuff like juggling eggs in this game to just show off your tech skills, so to speak. Just for fun to do while, as long as you keep your top speed. Just kind of show off with swag, as the kids call it. So this is called the pot shot. And what he did just now was he shot the pot off screen, and that causes it to break, and the key launches in the direction that Yoshi's, the opposite direction of what Yoshi's facing. So he turned around real quickly so the key would fly to him, he got it, and then went back over the lava.
Alright, so moving on to the first boss here. Bosses in this game are pretty unique if you compare them to like other games released around this time. So like, I think these are like a big step up from Super Mario World's bosses, for example. They're all pretty interesting. So for this guy, Kamek's gonna come in and like make him really big, and then you have to basically knock his pants off until he gets so embarrassed that he dies. So this fight's pretty basic. You just wait until he stops being invincible and then throw an egg at him. Not a whole lot to say. I'm just gonna be trying to make sure that I have 6 eggs after this level so I can turn them into red eggs for the auto-scroller coming up next. Did we ever explain the different egg colors?
I can do that.
Hi,
Yeah, go ahead. Want me to? Okay, yeah. When an egg hits a wall, it changes colors each time it hits a wall. So when it hits a wall once, it will turn yellow. When it hits it twice, it will turn red. The yellow egg, when it hits an enemy, will make a coin, and a red egg will make 2 stars. So in order to skip things like bonus rings in this level or star clouds, what he's going to do is make red eggs so he can shoot those eggs at enemies and not have to waste time getting stars through other methods.
Yep, and then that's going to be used pretty much everywhere. We like to skip a lot of the checkpoint rings, which give you 10 stars each, but they also pause the game to do that, so I'm going to try to be skipping all those I can. So first auto-scroller here. Kind of sucks that this game has auto-scrollers, but it only has 3 full-level auto-scrollers out of its 54 total levels, so it's not really a huge deal. But we like to spice these up with a little bit of swag if we can.
Actually, don't know why this works right here. Are you gonna go through the rock?
Yeah.
Do you know why that works?
You just duck and the screen kind of pushes you into the wall there. I don't know why it doesn't kill you, but it lets you just clip through that little section.
So as you see, Trix is bouncing green egg off of the floor and the wall, and then catching it to have a red egg so he can fire it at. Well, let's see what he fires it at. You can vary. You can fire it at a flower, star cloud, really. A lot of different mobs in the game can create stars when you hit them, but some can't. Some common enemies even can't. So it's interesting.
Mm-hmm. So there's a mid-ring over there, and I'm just not going to take that, because I'm going to make some stars with all these red eggs I just made.
Not a whole lot in this level, since it's an auto-scroller. Luckily, there aren't too many in this game. Only a few, compared to some other games. It's really not that bad. Makes a shy guy new home. So various form of swag. This bonus skip, you just flutter at the edge of the screen and kind of scroll with it, not pressing a direction. So, it's kind of neat.
Yep, and it's really nice that that works, because if that didn't work, there would probably not be any bonus skip for this level. It'd just be random whether or not you get one. Which would really suck, because right now, at the moment, there's only one level that doesn't have a bonus skip. So, it's not too bad. It's like 15 seconds that you could possibly lose, but that's not until super late in the run.
1-6 is pretty interesting because it introduces a new type of egg. It's a flashing red egg, and what that does is when you can't make them normally, they're usually hidden in levels, and when you shoot it at something, it creates a red coin. So basically, if you whiff it, you're not going to 100% the level because you're not going to get all 20 red coins.
Yep, so we tend to do pretty safe shots with those flashing eggs there, and I just stopped talking for a second to make sure I can hear the sound effect that flower gave me. Something interesting about this game is, wait a sec here. Alright, got it. Most of the collectibles in this game actually give you a sound when you get them, so it's really nice. Sort of a nice peace of mind thing. And you usually know if you don't hear something that you have to go back and get it because you probably missed it.
Sometimes they can play tricks on you, though. It's pretty annoying.
Yeah, on occasion. Keep going. Like sound effects will play over each other, so you won't always hear it, but usually you do.
This is one of those transformations I was talking about throughout the game. Yoshi can transform into different vehicles. I think they're all vehicles, at least. And helps them get. We try to skip them as much as possible because it takes time, but some like that you need to transform.
So here there's a little beanstalk in that cloud. Normally you like open it up and let it grow and it'll make these platforms that you can jump up, but you can just use the enemies around to flutter up there as well. So, going into 1-7, probably one of the more memorable levels, if you've ever played this game. you want to explain what's so good about this level, Mario Man?
Oh, well, there are two things. One, the melon bugs, which they're these little bugs that turn into balls that just slide around. They're adorable. One of the best mobs. The other thing is fuzzies, which everyone has probably seen, like, memes and such about Yoshi getting high off of fuzzies. They can waste some time if you get hit by them because they'll make the ground like a hill, which I haven't even spoken about that. So if you run down hills in this game, it actually takes time, more time than if you were to just jump down them. Same goes for obviously running up a hill. So that's why you'll see Trix jumping a lot. I don't know if I'd already explained that, but that fuzzies make the ground all hill-like, so.
Dang. Missed the backup shot here. And I don't want to use too many eggs since I'm going to need a lot of them for this next screen.
this next screen's pretty cool. If you scroll the camera up at the same time as jumping, it will go up high enough for the red egg or for the red coins to spawn, so you can shoot at them without having to make a beanstalk and go up there.
Yep, and then the bonus skip there is just ducking at a specific point in the ground and running forward. That's what a lot of them are going to be.
Dude, I like the train. That's the best vehicle, I have to say. Looks so cool.
Train's pretty good, but I think I'm a fan of the car. Though it doesn't actually get seen at all in the run, because there's only one in the game, I think. And we actually can skip it, unfortunately, so...
Yeah.
We do.
So when it's the first fortress of the game, there's... I don't know, there's a few interesting things. There's another pot shot, which we'll see soon, but... There's an interesting star route to skip a mid-ring. So you'll see Trix shooting first that flower and then like do a backwards neutral shot, which is, I don't know if I explained neutrals as being just quickly pressing and releasing A, and that's because we're on hasty controls to make stars on that flower.
Yeah.
And then
neutrals
lots of bouncing,
are a
just
super vital part of the run. I'm gonna use another one here. It's probably like half the egg shots in the game are neutrals, which is why we run on hasty.
And it's important because it's just a fast way to fire an egg, and at the same time you get to bounce it off walls quickly and just keep Yoshi's speed at top pace, so.
Alright, pretty good 1-8.
Yeah, for sure.
So, Selvo here is the second boss in the game. This boss, the boss itself anyway, can't actually hurt you at all. He's just like this big gooey blob. And then you want to like throw your eggs through him. Because the more time the eggs spend inside of him, the smaller he gets. So I just fire a few mostly horizontal shots here. And then a vertical shot at the end to finish him off.
Yeah, luckily we've come up with ways over the years, or before I was even in the community, just fast ways to kill these bosses that normally would take a while.
Yeah. And that is it for World 1. Thank you, Steva.
Yeah, that was a pretty good salvo. One thing that you become good at, like, after a lot of time playing the game, is it seems like a lot of these angles are really weird, and how do you calculate them? But eventually, it just is kind of second nature. Like, you just are able to see how an egg flies. Bounces off of stuff.
Yeah, you have to end up getting super familiar with the game's mechanics here, especially throwing eggs. It's probably the most important mechanic to this category, honestly. It's what really separates it from the any percent categories. So here I'm gonna get a pixel perfect shot to actually break through the other side of this gate, and that's it. And then I just throw another egg up there. So, if you want to explain, like, how the egg gets through there, Mario Man, like, how it dies.
Yeah, that's, speaking of angles, it bounces off the walls in a way that when the egg dies and falls down, do eggs only bounce on walls 5 times in this game?
I think it's 3 bounces and they die in the 4th.
Okay, whatever, amount of bounces an egg goes through, there's a limit before it dies and you can't catch it anymore. So basically, the egg dies, and the way it falls through the gate and opens it, which normally Yoshi would need to fall through that gate. So it's pretty cool, because you can just skip, normally you'd transform into Baby Mario there.
Yep, and that is a trick that's used in a whole bunch of places in this run. It's called a gate hack. That's probably the coolest one, the first one there.
Yeah,
because it's like a pixel perfect angle you have to get. And then there's another one like that later on in this world.
Oh jeez. Holy moly. Shit is close, dude.
Like that.
Not marathon safe. You don't need to do that, but you know. That's part of the swag in this game, as I was saying. Just do cool stuff during auto-scrollers and such. This is a pretty interesting level for 100% because of the falling rocks. If you don't get everything the first time through the level, or if you mess up, you're gonna have to kill yourself or replay the level. So, because it will get, like that flower, for instance, would have gotten covered by the rocks.
Yeah, it's pretty annoying, but it looks like we're good here. Aw, dang. I didn't know that emote was gonna be in this chat. Not bad though.
The cute tricks emote. It's pretty good. It's why you need sub button, dude.
Mm-hmm. We'll see. Maybe eventually. All right. So
2-2.
2-2. Yeah, dude. 2-2 is like one of the hypest levels in the run. Yeah.
It's awesome.
We skip a whole bunch of otherwise really boring stuff. So right here, I'm going to make an enemy come down. I get hit intentionally because I want this guy to come down. And I'm going to use him to skip a big section in a second here. Missed my jump. Alright, do a few extended flutters to skip that beanstalk, and then Mario Man can explain what's going on here with these red coin duplications as I do them.
Yeah, so normally with these fly guys, if you eat them, that's it. They only drop one red coin, obviously. But if you spin them off screen and they're alive, and then before the red coin despawns, go off the screen, load them back in, they'll be back carrying red coins. So it's going to skip a transformation in this level, so you don't need to waste more time. It's pretty cool. It's very helpful. There are a lot of levels where you'll see us doing that. Or where you'll see Trix doing that. I'll be talking about it. Level, yeah, I think this is personally my favorite level in the game. There's a lot to do. There's a lot of ways that if you mess up, though, it's going to cost a lot of time because there are a lot of specific angles and the star routes. I don't know. There's not a lot of easy ways to recover from what I know. So it's definitely one of the harder levels in the game.
Yeah, for sure, dude. Like, runs pretty much don't start until they get past 2-2. Alright, so there is the mole bubble. If you're doing a casual playthrough, you would actually take that, and there's 3 red coins in this section, but here, I already duped 2 of those red coins, so I don't need them, and then I shoot the last one with a pixel-perfect shot through that tiny hole.
And that shot quickly, you might have not been able to see it. It made a red egg right before it hit that, Star Cloud, so he was able to get 7 stars. Oh yeah, by the way, Star Clouds get 5 stars typically. Sometimes if there's a lot of lag though, some can despawn and that can be very unfortunate.
Yep, and then another Z-Wing spit for the bonus skip. And that's 2-2. Glad I got out of there not losing any time.
Hey, Scoob.
Hey, Scoob. Alright, so here, 2-3, I'm gonna try to get past all these gusties without really stopping at all.
Some minor RNG that can be pretty annoying. And at the beginning here, this level is a perfect example, I think, of how neutral shots are used, because so many shots in this beginning of this level, like in this cave portion here, it's all neutrals.
Yeah. Alright, so shooting that cloud the way I did actually locked the screen up there, which is important because it stops that baby Mario star from loading in right away. So normally if you were to just run through that as fast as possible, you'd actually touch it, which you don't want to do because you want to make a whole bunch of eggs in that section there. But because the game kind of locks the cloud up there, if you hit it, it doesn't scroll the screen all the way down.
That's the first time we see the, that's an interesting angle, by the way. That's the first time we see the, what is he called, the guy on the cover of the game?
Nepinet, I guess, in English.
Yeah,
that's what the levels say.
So, he's on the cover of the game, but really we don't see him too often, only in a few levels.
Now, there's a lava one in 1-4 as well.
Yeah. This bonus skip is weird, sometimes it just doesn't work. I don't know why that is.
Yeah, so, slopes in this game are really weird, so, like Mario Man said earlier, you want to kind of avoid jumping on slopes because they slow you down. But if you touch a slope and then jump off of it, it actually can lock in your speed at a weird value, and that can make you hit the gold ring at a weird time, and then that can kind of mess up your bonus skip on occasion. But there's ways to kind of circumvent that, if you know how it works.
Perfect jump?
Perfect jump would be one way. Another way is just doing a bunch of small hops, either as you're on the slope or when you jump off of it.
I guess I can take that opportunity to explain perfect jump. Perfect jump is just when you land on the ground and then jump the same frame you land. So, I don't think the game really counts you as landing on the ground,
it never recognizes you as touching the ground.
And that was a normal gate hack, we do a lot of those in the run. It's has to do with a dead egg just activating the gate so Yoshi can go through it.
Yep, so the route we take through this level differs pretty heavily from the intended route. Alright, got both those coins. It's a pretty hard shot.
Yeah, honestly, after doing this for so long, I don't even remember the intended route on this level.
Yeah.
We skip, like, staircases and all sorts of stuff you see in these clouds here that normally you'd make. So it's coming up here. It's called a perfect flutter. And if you stop fluttering and repress the button, the B button, to flutter within 3 frames... Is it? Of
yeah, it's
the
like
fluttery,
three or four
you'll gain
frames.
Height. What was that?
It's like 3 or 4 frames. But yeah, it's a pretty tight window.
So you'll gain some height. Normally if you were to just flutter there, he wouldn't have made it up. Another gate hack,
and then I'm gonna duck here and just throw another neutral to get that flower. And then I have a kind of interesting route for this room, just because I like to have a whole bunch of eggs. Stationary eggs in the ground are pretty interesting. You can actually influence their speed pretty heavily by using Yoshi's tongue. They kind of try to follow Yoshi in the air, so you can kind of juggle them around and try to, like I did there, get that that one egg kind of juggled a few times over to me.
Their hitbox is actually much larger than they show, too.
Yeah. So, this is the third boss of the game. You just can't look at him, you gotta throw your eggs against the wall. This is probably one of the more boring bosses.
Bad RNG can kind of screw with you, though, sometimes.
It can, on occasion.
I think the next level, 2-5, is another one of those hype levels, like 2-2. There's a lot of, it's just like fast pace and you spit a lot of enemies in different directions. It's pretty cool.
Yeah, this level's a fan favorite for sure. People tell me all the time this is like their favorite level. But it used to be one of my least favorite because it's just so difficult to play well.
Yeah, and if you accidentally ground pound, you'll go through the foam and kill yourself, so it's pretty bad.
Yeah, that's another thing. still hate that jump.
Yeah. It's a pretty annoying jump. That's an, so you'll see he only got 14 stars there. This game has star RNG, is what I call it. When stars are released from a cloud or get created from a red egg, they'll jump in a random direction when they come out. So sometimes it'll be a little crazy and Yoshi won't get all of the stars. So oftentimes faster to just keep going and find a new way to get stars rather than going back and getting them too.
Yeah, I might try to make a red egg or something in the hallway coming up. So this is I think the first train section, right?
Yeah.
And I just did a little screen scroll at the beginning. I just kind of went onto the left rail for a little bit so those enemies wouldn't load in. Because those shy guys in the walls will actually hurt you if they touch you.
That right there, that red egg, is why Hundo, in my opinion, is such a cool category, is because you have to just think on the spot and improvise when you're in trouble. This last screen is really fast and can get hit pretty darn easily. There's a lot of ways to recover, though.
Aw, man, that was RNG. That was pretty unlucky. It almost never happens. That daisy, the daisy's spitting bubbles. We actually do a screen scroll just before that daisy loads in, so it actually loads in later. It doesn't have as much of a chance to spit bubbles, but if it decides to spit them super early, it can still kind of block you, and that's really annoying. But pretty good 2-5, just got some bad RNG at the end.
Not too bad. Sometimes you can jump on those bubbles and make Yoshi bounce and you'll end up like hitting the Lakitu or something. It's pretty unfortunate.
So there's another crazy gate hack shot coming up here and then another cool shot right after it. So that's a pixel perfect shot. You'll see a gate down there. The gate hasn't actually loaded in at this point, so we use that to our advantage, just kind of get an egg through there with a very specific angle. And the shot I did right after kind of goes through the flower that I got, and then once the flower is loaded in, it comes back and picks it up, so that way you can get the red coin behind it as well.
Yeah, you'll see the flowers when they're not loaded in, they kind of look like they're sleeping, which is kind of interesting that they, like when the flowers weren't, quote, spawned, they still had a sprite on the screen. It's pretty cool.
Alright, and then the next shot is the last of the three really difficult shots in this level. And I got it. Nice. So you just kind of try to angle your shot and lock it in as you jump up there. Probably is harder than it looks. It's kind of a tight window to actually get the egg through there without losing any speed or upwards momentum. Alright, so here I want at least three eggs, so I'm gonna grab one from there.
Does leaving that little dot of foam save time?
I believe it is slightly faster.
Yeah. You skip going down there and under.
Yeah.
Just standard Z-Wing skip for the bonus.
Hit. Pretty nice end of the level there. I like the sun in the background.
This next level will have duping again right at the beginning, and it introduces a new enemy, the fat shy guys. I don't know what they're actually called, just big shy guys. And they make Yoshi have a giant egg in his... I like calling it an arsenal. Sounds pretty cool. So Yoshi will have a giant egg in his arsenal. And using that will kill all enemies on the screen, turning them into stars. And then it will also, you can also just get coins off of it, I think. Just bring it to a goal ring. It can't transfer into another level, which is kind of unfortunate.
So here I'm going to try to skip that mid-ring. I was supposed to actually eat a fat shy guy earlier, but I accidentally killed him, so... That's fine, I'll figure out something else. I might just take the other mid-ring in this
mid-ring,
level.
Mid-ring, yeah. Yeah, there is something called a Baxter shot, which you can, like, juggle the egg to be past the goal ring so Yoshi will run through it. And it will, because it will land on the ground and not break. So you can do that with things like eggs or even big keys if this was a TAS. Or keys. I mean.
Oh, nice. I got that shot. That shot's pretty specific.
Yeah,
get both those coins
sure.
with one egg. I didn't even really expect to be getting it.
The big egg can break clouds and such, but it's not really worth it to use. I don't know if we explained egg shuffling, but it's a little late for that, but still. If you press Y while Yoshi's aiming an egg, he'll push it to the back of the line of eggs.
Mm-hmm.
So, in order to not use the big egg, it's often just... Ooh. It really scares me, walking like right through the little car bubble.
Yeah, when it moves up and down, it's actually its hitbox moving as well, so it's pretty safe to go under it.
There's also a helicopter transformation, which doesn't make any sense, but...
Yeah, I don't know why that's even there. I think you just get some coins with it or something. But we don't need either of those transformations. Way faster to just skip them. So 2-8 coming up is one of the longer levels in this game. There's just like really long corridors that you have to run through multiple times.
Get off the rails, I'll explain it.
Yeah, there I just did a pipe glitch. You might have seen me a few times when I go down pipes, I actually kind of jump off of them. And what that is if you jump the same frame you go down a pipe, Yoshi skips the going down the pipe animation and just like does a jump instead. And that saves about 29 frames every time you do it, so almost half a second. It's a pretty nice time save. But I'm not going to be getting it on every pipe. Some pipes actually cause major glitches if you do pipe glitches off of them, so it's not even allowed in this category to do it off of some pipes.
Yeah, you'll be put into 1-1. So, there are some categories where you'll go through the level, warp to 1-1, and then finish the level there to count it.
Yep.
What Trix was trying for there, but he didn't quite get, it was called off the rails. Basically, if you get the bubble at like a specific height, I believe, and like location horizontally, when you turn into the train, you can skip a portion of the track, and it saves a few seconds.
Yeah, that was just a minor instance of it. It would save like half a second if I got it, but there's a pretty major skip using off the rails later on. But fortunately for that one, we actually have a setup, so it's not like a huge deal.
Yeah. This is pretty cool because just by ground pounding here, it messes up the Shy Guy's rhythm, so you can just keep pushing the pot and they don't,
Yep, don't have to stop at all.
Don't drop a bomb on you. The pot shot, I just learned this actually, doesn't work right there because pots actually spawn one tile above the ground, so they fall off screen. And I think just because of the way, like where it's located, it wouldn't work because it can't fall onto the ground. Being on that large platform. Mm-hmm. It's lots of long just corridors that aren't really that exciting in this level.
Yeah, and then tons of door transitions as well, which take a long time to animate through. Alright, I'm glad I didn't mess up that Burt room. That ground pound can be kind of tricky.
You'll You'll see tricks like being in different Yoshi poses when he goes through doors and such, like that pipe right there. That's because Yoshi can, in the SNES version, he can't do it in Game Boy. He can do any sort of movement and still go through the door as long as you're pressing up. It's pretty cool. Mm-hmm. So you can get some funny looking sprites. Favorite trick? Geez, I don't know. You mean like basic mechanic or like a big part of the run? Like a special?
It probably means like specific tricks, like skips and stuff like that, since he said switch jump. Switch jump is definitely a really good one. That'll be coming up in the next world. Isn't there something in World 5 that people tend to really like? I can never remember what it is, but I don't know. There's some skip. I think it's in 5-4? I don't know. I don't really get what the big deal is about it, but people seem to really like it. I don't know. We'll see when we get there, I guess.
Yeah, we'll see when we get there. It's something I've heard of it once or twice. It's I hear it's pretty easy, but I think for me, I really like Lava Skip, which is basically just doing a lot of extended flutters. It's kind of boring sounding, but to me, when I get it, I get really excited. So.
Yeah, Lava Skip's a classic.
Also, in World 5, if you're there's this one shot that this is kind of getting off track from where we should be, but you kill these spikes when you're running on ice, and you can just run through it. And like, if you miss it though, you're gonna die and lose a ton of time.
Oh man, yeah, that shot's pretty cool.
Yeah, it's a cool shot.
There's tons of really neat egg shots in this category.
Next is World 3, which is I love World 3. It's like a jungle-themed world, and there are monkeys everywhere, and there's a lot of RNG with monkeys, and they spit watermelon seeds. It's pretty exciting stuff.
Yeah, so. Which is interesting, because most new players for this game really hate World 3. I think it's because there's so much enemy RNG, which doesn't really lose time, but you have to kind of adapt around it. Gotta figure out what all the enemies are going to be doing, so I think that's why most new players kind of have some trouble with it, but it's one of my favorite worlds for sure.
If you would have asked me a few months ago, I would have said it's my least favorite, but it's become one of my favorites. Mm-hmm. Monkeys are pretty cool, because when you throw them at something like a cloud, they don't break like a normal enemy. They just bounce off, so you can either make an egg out of them or re-grab them, spit them again. It's pretty cool. They have like a sleeping form when you hit them once.
Oh man. I didn't really want this watermelon.
Good thing it's a half-eaten one.
Yeah. Hopefully that won't happen again. Sometimes you can get kind of trolled when you try to tongue these monkeys holding watermelons. Your tongue just kind of goes through them and you get the watermelon instead.
What monkeys? A lot of people also don't like this world because it's very easy to, I don't know if it has to do with watermelons specifically, I think it might. Red coins can despawn, and you can think you either got them or they aren't there, and you'll miss it at the end of the level. Like, you'll realize at the end of the level, oh my gosh, I only got 19 red coins.
Yeah, that's one thing that can happen, and then also, specifically with this level, and I guess also the one coming up next, if you get hit on the last screen here, there's really no way to recover at all. So you basically just have to kill yourself if you take any damage there.
Yeah, not really any walls or anything to quickly make eggs off of, and monkeys are one of the mobs that don't create stars when you fire an egg at them.
Yeah.
Along with Milts, which you'll see in this level, they look like little Kirbys. He just fired a egg at a fly guy off screen, so he didn't need to wait for it to come down or anything.
Aw, man. Got kinda unlucky with some of those egg shots. Gonna have to do a backup shot in a second here.
I'm interested to see what you have for this backup shot, so. I think this game definitely gets it would be less tiring to run than other games because there's so much creativity to how you can play it. There's so many different strats, and you can really just vary a lot of your play. It's very cool. It's like I compare it to Melee a lot, Smash Brothers Melee.
Yeah, for sure. No two players use all of the same strats, and some players vary wildly between what strats they do. Because there's just so much you can do in this game, so many ways to kind of collect everything without really losing any time compared to other strats. So it's pretty interesting to see the kind of variety you get between runners.
That was an example of Trix was pressing pause to see that he got everything because the sounds, as we were saying earlier, can kind of overlap each other and some can get cut out, so he didn't hear the 20 red coins sound.
Just wanted to be sure. I was kind of focusing on, or trying to think of like where I was going to make a star backup, so I wasn't really paying a whole lot of attention to the coins I was getting, so I just wanted to be sure. It's way better to do that than to replay the whole level.
Yeah.
Alright, that shot at the start there is pretty rough. Glad I got it.
Yeah, that is a difficult shot. This is a very long level. This is the first time we do the submarine transformation. It's pretty cool, but it's pretty slow if you mess up on the submarine transformation.
So here I'm just gonna try to kind of make sure I have 6 eggs before I move on to the next area. Could be pretty egg intensive. And then there's actually 2 transformations in this level. One of them is the helicopter here. I don't really know why it's here. It's kind of weird. There's only like a very small area you have to get through here. But
is this the first helicopter we've done? Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, I think it is. There's actually supposed to be one in 1-2, but we skip it, so you never really see it. And then here's a submarine.
Submarines. You can explain if you want.
So they're kind of boring. Most transformations in this game are. Basically, you just kind of swim through the water, and you have these missiles that you can use, which actually are RNG. They'll randomly go after an enemy around them, which is kind of annoying sometimes. Not specifically really in this level, but it could be kind of bad in one of the later levels in World 3. So there's only 1 red coin to worry about in this section, so it's not too bad. And you can mostly just dodge the enemies without really having to shoot a bunch of missiles at them.
Red coins in this game have a slightly different tint, if you couldn't tell. They are slightly red on the screen. For example, that middle one and that set of 3. And being underwater, it's often difficult for newer players because all of the coins have that tint. So you have to memorize which exact coin is a red coin. You go underwater. For a while, you can have that crutch. Ooh.
Yeah, so that shot there is one of the trolliest shots in the game, for sure. I got every coin except the one I actually wanted from it, which kind of sucks. But it's super hard to get like the exact angle you want there. To not have to actually swim through any of that. Alright, and there, I actually just checked how many stars I had again. But this time I threw a red egg at something to make sure it didn't spawn any stars rather than pausing the game, and that's faster.
It's actually pretty smart.
Yeah.
Yeah. A bonus skip can be a little weird. Usually if I don't jump off of the monkey at the end and I spit, I get a bonus. So, Yoshi's speed's weird jumping off the stairs, I think. Might have to do the mud, too.
It's probably to do with the mud. Jumping off of enemies is actually usually not a good thing to do, because that'll usually do weird things to your speed. So, do a few shots, get through those spikes, and there's another submarine section. There's tons of them in this world, although fortunately it's the only world that has any submarines, so after World 3 you don't really see any more. This one doesn't have any enemies, it's just 2 red coins and a spike ball.
Luckily it's short, and yellow submarine's the coolest looking one in my opinion.
Yeah, for sure.
These spear guys, you're going to see tricks tonguing. You can't actually tongue them forward. They'll be pushed back because of their shields. But you can do an up tongue and get them. And the reason why you're seeing him do it so close is because obviously he'd be slowed down. So you can't really tell that it's an up tongue.
Yeah, and also for the up tongue to even hit, you have to be like touching them basically.
It's pretty precise timing.
So here, you have to come into this room with, that was scary, with six red eggs, or six eggs, and you do six neutrals, and if you miss any of those shots, you have to exit the room and, come back and get a bunch of eggs. So that's scary. If the crabs, move kind of in a weird way, it's not good.
Sometimes they can just troll you. It sucks.
Definitely.
This is just doing extended flutters to skip the pinwheel here.
Man, I was trying to turn backwards so that didn't happen.
That's an example of an egg hitbox being very large. It's just annoying.
Didn't even want to tongue that there. Alright, so normally you'd want to shoot eggs at the crab coming up here. But I'm actually going to damage boost through it, because I only have three eggs, and I would have to get another egg from the egg block if I didn't. So, I'll just do that.
This room can be kind of nerve-wracking because of those two jumps. There's just, it's one tile.
Yeah. Pretty tight.
This boss, I believe, afterwards you have no eggs, so it doesn't matter how many you go into here with.
Mm-hmm.
So, just, you can spit the frogs. Isn't it really cool boss, actually?
Yeah, this is probably the most memorable boss in the game, honestly. Normally Kamek makes your enemies bigger, but in this case he actually makes Yoshi smaller, and then the frog eats him.
The face he makes is great. Do you have the,
let's
see, the FFZ on here? Oh, you don't have it on FFZ?
Nah, I forgot. I'll have to get that. So this fight is pretty interesting. Eggs don't always do the same damage to the uvula up here. It actually depends on where specifically in the uvula you hit. So I'm going to be throwing them kind of at an angle up into the ceiling, so they kind of ricochet and hit the uvula from the side, which does the most damage. Except for the last shot, because then it doesn't matter, because he's already taken enough damage.
Yeah, and did you say, already standing in the center there, you don't really take, is it spit falling? What is it, acid?
It's like stomach acid or something. Yeah, yeah. So that fight can be really dangerous. The stomach acid, I didn't even mention, stomach acid that falls down from the ceiling is also random. So, you can actually get patterns that are so bad that it's kind of impossible to dodge. Doesn't happen very often, but sometimes you have to get pretty creative with your dodging there, or you'll have to basically reset because you lose a ton of time getting hit there.
This level right here, the first screen, is really, really cool. Just lots of fast egg shots and just running forward. That, one of the red coins right there is one that's very easy to despawn. I've done it where I've gotten to the end of the level and then had to come all the way back to the beginning before. So the monkey's always having that hitbox, him just up spitting it, landed in that pit. Really convenient, so you can just keep going fast and get your stars and everything.
Yep, it's pretty cool up spit. This egg shot's pretty cool if I get it.
Yeah. Those green piranha plants. Oh.
It's fine.
Those green piranha plants. No. normally take 3 hits to kill, but you'll see later. I think 3/8, the first level where we'll see it, is you can spit through. You can spit an enemy or fire an egg, and it's, I believe, 24 frames. You can go through the prone plant and not get hit.
Yep, that's super useful in a bunch of places. They don't really appear until later on, though. I think 3/8 is the first appearance of them.
Yeah. Or the first where we'll use it to our benefit. This level's pretty cool. You're gonna use a little mousers. They're called to just jump and skip a staircase animation. Or, my bad, beanstalk.
Yep. And then...
And this is a switch jump.
Well, that's coming after the mole section. But yeah, so there's another mole section here. These are pretty basic. Kind of boring. But after this, there is a pretty interesting trick called switch jump or yump. And that is not quite frame perfect. It's a 3-frame, not a window. Oh my god. It's actually 3 specific frames you can get it on, but they're all separated by like dead frames that won't work. It's really annoying. So we'll see what happens here. It's in this cloud. All right, not bad, dude. So
nice,
that's super
man.
Hard jump to get. Really glad I got it.
It's saves like what, 8 seconds or something like that.
Man, it's like 12 to 14.
Yeah, it's because you have to jump off the switch, and then there's a little animation, and then you have to run all the way to the end.
Yeah,
it saves a lot of time.
It's definitely a pretty big time save. It's not quite the point where like you basically need that shot to get world record, but it's getting there, and I'm not looking forward to needing to reset over switch jump. That isn't gonna be fun.
20 eggs.
Mm-hmm.
That's fine. Three-seven. I think the beginning of the level is really cool because it shows some of the instances of the monkeys being able to just be used multiple times. See him upspit it here, then catch it, and then upspit it again. But the fish, I think, for the most part, are random, and sometimes you'll get lucky and just be at like top speed, and then get a fish to jump off of.
Yeah.
And just keep going.
Fish are some of the more annoying enemies in this game. They're extremely random. So there's fish that'll randomly jump up from the water, and you have to try to like just react quickly enough. But then worse than that. There's a specific kind of fish, you didn't even see it because I got unlucky earlier in that screen, where you want 2 of them to jump up, and then you can bounce off of them and not flutter across that water. I didn't actually get either of them, so I had to flutter quite a bit. That's pretty annoying.
Right there, you have to be pretty careful tonguing the monkeys, because if they're holding the bomb above their head and you tongue them, the bomb can just go flying in a direction and hit Yoshi.
Mm-hmm.
So, can suck.
Alright, so if you ground pound across there quickly enough, you can actually get down there before the Shy Guys get in your way. And then you can do that Shy Guy spit plus jumping neutral to quickly clear out all that stuff.
This screen can be a little nerve-wracking because these big fish here, if they eat you, you just die in one hit. So sometimes we'll skip that middle ring that Trix just got if we have a red egg. And if you die by the fish, you're going to have to replay. I think all of the level.
Yeah, it's the whole level. There's no other mid-ring that we get.
Or in other words, reset.
Yeah. Pretty much isn't worth continuing the run if that happens.
You have to make sure you end the level with at least 5 eggs here, because at the beginning of 3-8, there's an enemy that takes four eggs to get past, so.
Yep. And you want a fifth one for another egg shot right after. So I'm going to do some neutrals here, try to get stars off of this guy. And then you can actually just tongue your way through that piranha fish there. Which is pretty nice.
Pretty useful. This level is very, very egg intensive.
Definitely. Kind of to the point where it's sort of annoying for this room.
Yeah.
So you have to stop and hit a bunch of egg blocks. So one thing I'm doing, one little mechanic in this game, is when you see me turning around at some points, I actually tongue the walls. That's because it stops Yoshi's momentum entirely. So whenever you want to quickly turn around, it's best to tongue the walls. And there, there's that green piranha. So like we were saying earlier, after you hit them, they kind of get invincible, but they also don't have a hitbox or a hurtbox at all. So Yoshi can move through them, or you can shoot eggs through them. It's pretty nice.
And there, if you shoot one of those, what do you call those big, the pile of boo? I don't know.
Yeah, I think that's what they're called. It's kind of weird.
Oh, really? So, if you fire an egg off screen and he spawns or becomes bigger as that egg's, just as the egg would hit him, it's going to do that, just make him smaller. So, pretty handy.
Yep, and then here's the other green piranha on this level. Ah, dang. Alright, well.
That's, I think, the hardest green piranha to get past in the game.
Definitely.
Because you're fluttering.
So, like, normally when you go through green piranhas, you're going to be moving pretty fast, but for that one, you're moving slow, so it's a pretty tight window. Hardest boss in the game right here.
Yeah.
Oh my.
It's really cool.
Mm-hmm. It's like a developer intended Easter egg. You just kind of hit the boss before Kamek can come in, and he dies instantly.
But I've seen people lose runs too. If they only have one egg and they just don't want to spend any time getting another, missing it, and
yeah,
activating the boss, that can be pretty unfortunate. So
don't really want to YOLO that shot.
Marathon save three eggs from the guys at the end there.
Yeah, I figured I may as well since I had to wait for them to come down anyway. Hey, what's up, ZFresh?
World 4 is personally my favorite world. There's so much cool stuff. It also introduces Goombas, which you'd expect for a Mario game to be here a lot sooner.
Yeah, I think this is the only level in the game with Goombas.
I think a few others have them. But, do they? I don't know. We'll see. I'll pay extra close attention this time. This level's called Go Go Mario. It's also my favorite level title. I think it's really great.
So, pretty nice first screen there. We have it down pretty optimized. You want to make tons of eggs there, obviously, without losing speed. And then there you make four stars, which lets us skip a mid-ring.
It's actually pretty new. I don't do that strat yet. It's pretty interesting. There's a lot of interesting egg shots in this level that you just fire neutral. For example, there you just fired at the melon cloud, but you don't even get the melon. And this level also brings back fuzzies, which are from 1-7. But this time, it can be pretty unfortunate because, as I said, the ground gets all wavy when you get fuzzied. And these little thin platforms here, if they're it's hard to explain, but if they're wavy, they can become, like, horizontally, what am I looking for? Like, the right side can be higher than the left, and Yoshi can just run through it, because the game will not think of it as a slope, it will just think of it as, like, a broken platform.
Yeah, it's pretty annoying. I wish they would have seen that before they released the game. The world record actually dies there and loses, like, 20 seconds or something. Super dumb.
Yeah. That's a first Baby Mario transformation. It's pretty cool.
Yep.
Can run up hills and walls with it.
Man, normally you would have seen that way back in, like, 2-1 and also in 2-2 and 2-3. Yeah. We skip a whole bunch of them.
And he's also invincible to spikes and can run straight through enemies, which is really cool.
Alright, 4-2 is another fan favorite level. There's one section which has some really cool egg shots as you're, like, falling down. It's pretty neat. Also kind of difficult.
Here he'll do an egg shot to skip needing to go all the way up there and pushing that crate off and then breaking the cloud. He just does two rising shots to get the cloud and then the star.
So here are those egg shots I was talking about. Alright, got him.
That right there was a pretty good example of star RNG. Like, if Trix had gotten hit earlier in the level and he needed to recover, he would have counted on those stars and he would have lost even more time because they spawned pretty far away. This section can be a pain because if you use those arrows up, it's kind of difficult to get either that coin or that flower.
Yeah, you actually would have to do a perfect flutter to recover, and there's no real way to tell if you got the perfect flutter, so you can pretty easily actually run out of eggs and then just kind of be screwed.
4-3 is my favorite level in the game. Oh boy, this is it's pretty cool. There's a lot of vertical climbing, which you don't often see in 2D platformers in general, so I think it's really cool and unique for that reason. So the only part that's not that great is there's a helicopter transformation, but if this was TAS, you're able to... You are technically able to skip it. It's very hard.
Yeah, it's like not quite TAS only. I'll probably implement it kind of soon, but it is pretty ridiculous. Skip this helicopter here, and it doesn't even save that much time because you have to do really weird stuff to do it.
So this segment right here is just, like, too much fun. Climb up and jump off of the bullet bill, and you just basically are able to do all this stuff at top speed. Not lose anytime, just keep going up. It's really cool.
So here's another piranha clip.
It's a nicer one, because you're just falling off the platform, so for timing, that's all you need to rely on. Right here, you normally need to take a balloon, but instead Trix is just running and he's gonna get to, after the fourth arrow on this new set, look up and just shoot a flower, and that's all he's missing. Then he's gonna do a lot of extended flutters right over here to get to the goal area.
Yep, and 4-3 is interesting because it's the only level in the game that has two exits, two gold rings. And unfortunately, it doesn't like lead you to a secret level or anything like in Super Mario World. But you do need to go to the kind of secret one if you want to get all the red coins. So 4-4, arguably the coolest level in World 4.
For
It's this
sure.
big fortress with like four branching paths, and you have to go down all of them to get all the keys. And just like with the way the rooms are designed, you do some really cool movement and egg shots.
Any of you guys are probably familiar with Trihex. This is he used to speedrun vanilla normal Yoshi's Island for how many years now?
Oh man, like 10 years he used to speedrun it for.
even more than that, because I think before he streamed even speedrunning it. But anyways, this is his favorite level.
Yeah, this is a lot of people's favorite level.
These blocks are pretty interesting. Green breaks in one hit, and then yellow two and red three. They're only used in this world, I believe. No, they're also used in World 5, but where are they?
4-8 also has some more.
Yeah, I was thinking of 4-8, not 5-8. But they're a pretty cool concept. They're also in World 6 in a boss battle. There's a lot going on in that room. It's pretty easy to get hit, so.
Pretty easy to get hit, pretty easy to despawn stuff as well. It's probably one of the major drawbacks of this game is rather than having the game lag, I guess the developers decided they would just have sprites despawn instead. But for some reason they made it so even like collectible sprites can despawn, which is really annoying.
Right here, Trix is skipping using the cookie. So he doesn't have to go on that little spinning platform that's also known as a cookie.
Yeah, we call it a cookie, but it
yeah.
may not make sense to everyone.
Saves a lot of time. All right, decent amount actually.
So there,
And
the
that.
key was in the cloud, and then I also, you have to do a perfect flutter to get up that platform, otherwise you have to wait for the pink platform. So that could be kind of annoying to miss, but I got it there. Alright, nice room. That room is probably the hardest one for me. There are some new shots discovered at the beginning of that room that I just started doing, and they're kind of tough.
This room can be kind of scary because lava kills you in one hit. It's if you slip off a platform or something, you can get in trouble.
If you slip off a platform, or if you accidentally do a perfect jump and don't realize it,
Yeah.
I don't think we mentioned this, but frame perfect jumps, not only does the game not really recognize you as touching the ground, but you also don't get an automatic flutter afterwards. So if you're expecting to get that flutter and you don't, you can land right in the lava, and that's really not good.
A lot of people intentionally wait just a little bit of time before jumping again in important areas like that because it can be pretty devastating. This upcoming boss fight's pretty cool because you can, Oh, you'll see, actually. I'll explain it when it happens.
Yeah, I will say it's pretty annoying because the hitboxes in this boss aren't super great, and if you don't really know how they work, then you can easily end up getting hit and losing tons of time or even the run. So,
Yeah.
it can be pretty annoying.
I've died like twice on this boss in a single run because of just. I'm not saying I'm good, but
Hitboxes are pretty bad.
yeah, they are.
Alright, but that was a pretty good fight. So, yeah. And basically you just kind of ground pound them, split them up into a bunch of small milds, and you try to kill all of them at the end with one egg.
And then you can get what I call the 2-for-1 special, which is ground pounding 2 milds at once there in the middle, with how you break them, the strat. So it's kind of cool.
So I think it's actually been a while since we did Red Coin Dupes. I think there hasn't really been any.
Yeah.
There isn't World 3 or anything. This level's going to have a little bit of Red Coin Duping, and that's to skip one of the rooms that you have to go pretty far out of your way to get to and only has 2 red coins.
It's also, I believe, the first double dupe we do, which creates 2 extra red coins,
ooh,
which you can only do in like a very... Whoa!
Couldn't get up that. I don't know why.
You can only do in a very small space. So, because if the first one despawns, then you're not able to get it.
Yeah, so...
There, he's got 3.
Double dupe there, and then rest of the level's pretty vanilla. Kind of interesting about this level, you're supposed to push this Chomp Rock through all of it to get past all these obstacles, but you can pretty much just use enemies and extended flutters to get through everything.
One interesting thing about enemies being in Yoshi's mouth, after a certain amount of time, I believe 20 seconds somewhere around that, I think maybe actually a little shorter amount of time, Yoshi will just automatically swallow it. So you'll see tricks if he ever has to carry an enemy for a long time, up spit it and then catch it again so Yoshi doesn't swallow it. And the cool thing about shells is Yoshi can't swallow them, so he could have kept that in his mouth for a very long time.
So this trick looks kind of scary, but I've literally never missed it, so I really wish new runners would like go for that more often. I think people just avoid it because I guess if you were to mess it up you would die, but it's pretty hard to mess up. You just jump under that kind of gray block in the middle, and then you get an automatic flutter, and then you can't really mess it up, so.
There's a Game Boy Advance version of this game, I brought it up before, and they fixed a lot of stuff. Like, you can't do that trick, whether it was intentional for them to fix it or not. It's one of those tricks that you can't do in that version. It's a lot different, but if someone has no other option for checking out this game, and really wants to play it, I'd actually recommend it. It's a lot of fun. That's how I got started on it.
Yeah, so there's a red coin over to the left behind that wall that I missed, and that's because this is another level where we duplicate red coins. This is probably the most dupe-intensive level of the game.
And if you screw one of them up, you have to... It's very hard to recover if you screw up one of the dupes.
Mm-hmm.
This one up here, you have to make sure before you collect the first red coin that you spawn this fly guy, or make sure he's on camera again before you collect it. This cave's really cool because it's a lot of people do it differently. I like to do it with a little bit of swag where I fire backwards to get some stuff. But there's a lot of just cool shots. Nice.
Yeah, lots of cool shots. After this room, there's actually like a hidden room connected to it, which has a bunch of red coins, and that's really what we're skipping by doing all these red coin dupes. You can kind of see it under the water there, maybe. I probably went by too fast.
Lower right hand corner.
So, 2 more dupes to do in this level. This one's a double dupe.
This screen's pretty nerve-wracking if you get hit. I mean, there are a lot of ways to recover. Ooh.
So, what happened there, I'll try to explain it as I do this dupe. Yoshi, when he ducks, has a ducking animation that he goes through. And so if you start ducking as you run off of a platform, he actually gets stuck in whatever frame of the ducking animation he was in.
So you did?
Yeah, so that's what I did. And you can't really get out of that until you land. So I kind of landed on that shy guy, and then I couldn't even flutter afterwards because I had to land on the ground first, so that was kind of annoying.
Couldn't you tongue out of it? If it was like from a higher height?
I think you can up tongue out of it, yeah. Nope, I didn't think of it at the time.
And Mr. Wolf, yeah, the setup you do, or how we did the boss in 4-4 is like very, very consistent. You'll rarely miss the double-double. That's a good one. I like that.
So here, I take this Koopa shell, and I use it to bounce up here, and that skips, whoa, what? That was...
Whoa!
Really weird. The egg went through the wall. I've never seen that happen.
I haven't seen that either.
Okay. I didn't know that could happen.
There's always stuff in this game that will just happen that you can't really recreate. That I don't know. I've never seen it. Maybe it's just because I watched this game and have played it a lot, but don't see it happen with other games, or there will just be one thing that will happen, and I'll never see it again. This last screen's pretty cool, and so is the bonus skip. You're able to fire an egg here to get the off-screen flower and by ricocheting it off that wall. And then the bonus skip's cool because you just jump off of the platform at the top speed and then keep running and go through the goal ring. You'll get it.
Yep, so you get like, if you jump off of a red platform while it's moving, you kind of get locked into a speed that's above what your normal max speed should be. So you can just run to the goal ring there, like Mario Man said. And yeah, Mr. Wolf. So for the 4-4 boss fight, at 100%, we really only do the single double. But you can do the double-double. Mostly it's done in any percent because it's got a pretty good risk of you getting hit.
Okay. Yeah, I only play 100%, so that's my knowledge is pretty limited in that respect, but...
So these are some pretty tight shots to shoot the blocks underneath those spike balls and then run through them. Just a few frames that you have to get under them.
There's going to be a pretty interesting... Well, first of all, Trix just tongued through the wall to get the cookie. If you, tongue and then jump afterward, Yoshi's tongue can go through walls. And right there, he skipped the mid-ring by activating the cloud and going through the ring at the same time. There's a pretty consistent visual cue, and it will just skip the mid-ring animation because I think it's overloaded, right?
Yeah, yeah. Oh my god, that was a flawless room.
That was beautiful.
Doesn't happen too often.
No. Just one egg that gets everything.
Yeah. Or I think it's two eggs, but...
Oh, yeah.
Still pretty crazy. Very specific egg shots for this room. Oh man, I didn't get enough height.
Now you run to the left there. I believe you can also just stay stationary and fire two neutrals. Am I right?
There might be alternative strats. I don't really know about them.
Dang.
Just a little bit of swag.
This is actually based off of a timer, so you can just stand still even, and the boss fight will start.
Mm-hmm.
You don't need to keep running. It's, in my opinion, the coolest boss. It's not the coolest boss, it's just my favorite boss. It's really fun.
Yeah, it's another one that has kind of annoying hitboxes, though.
Oh yeah, you can just get hit by bouncing on his head in a weird spot, too close to the front, or too close to the front of the shell. I used to think it was safer to jump on the back of the shell, but you can just randomly get hit, even if you're in a decent spot.
And then another thing, if you ground pound on the Koopa before he touches the ground, he actually slides backwards. And if you do it on the final hit, you get blast off. And that's a pretty neat trick. Doesn't save any time, but it looks pretty cool.
Yeah.
Blast off, rocket jump, moon jump. It's got tons of names. I think someone called it rocket launcher jump at some point. That's a classic.
If you do it from the other side, I think it takes... It actually does waste time. It kind of soft locks for 20 seconds or something, and Yoshi doesn't appear in the keyhole for quite a while.
Yeah, yeah, you definitely don't want to do it from the other side. I don't know why that happens. It's pretty weird.
It's weird.
And that's it for World 4. World 5 come up is the snow and ice level for World. Which means more than ever, you're going to want to not really be standing on the ground in a lot of places, because that'll slow you down a lot walking in snow.
I believe, are snow and mud the same or no in terms of like speedrunning through it, or no? Because mud can actually speed you up, or you can get faster through mud, right? Sometimes? Like gradually speed up?
I think mud might be closer to ice than it is to snow.
Yeah.
Alright,
but anyways, it's just bad stuff.
Gonna do another double dupe. And that'll skip getting a few red coins later on. Oh man. Jeez.
I don't know if
all my eggs. Holy moly. Let me through, please.
I get pretty hecked up on that sometimes, I think. There's a little bit of RNG involved. I don't know if it might have to do with camera scrolling, though.
Yeah, I don't know. It doesn't happen too often to me. I am going for a new strat there, so I guess that would be why, but kind of dumb.
So this skips a helicopter transformation? Because there's actually room to fly, like, way above these coins, but I think no. Were the dupes to get the red coins above there?
No, there's actually no red coins up there.
Okay, yeah, that's what I thought. It's just dumb.
Yeah. There's a red coin up to the left that we're skipping, and there's another secret room that we don't have to go through because of that double dupe.
Penguins can mess you up pretty bad sometimes if you're not expecting to bump into them. You can, they'll just bounce you in the other direction, and if you're caught off guard, you can fall into a pit or something.
And in this screen, basically if you let anything hit you, you pretty much can get comboed and get hit over and over, and it can be a disaster.
Yeah.
It's not good. But it looks like I'm safe. And the bonus skip here is just to run through that last little patch of snow. Slows you down just enough.
Is the only level that you cannot prevent a bonus. We've tried to lab it for a long time and come up with something, anything, to I thought I had something, but I just got really lucky whenever I did this one trick. So.
Yep, there's another perfect flutter to get up there without pushing this big snowball around. Let's see. Gonna ride this Lakitu cloud through all of this.
It's pretty great, actually. It's the only point in the game where you really do this.
Here,
I think the last screen.
Jump up those snowmen at a very specific angle, then you actually can gain speed off of them. It's kind of hard to do, but I got it there. What were you going to say, Mario Man?
I think this screen's very cool, because normally you need to take these ski lifts here, but it's possible to just bounce off of all of these penguins floating around and get to the goal that way. It's pretty cool.
Yep. So we'll see how kind RNG is going to be to me. I like to spit that penguin at the end. It seems to make things more consistent. It's probably just my imagination. And, yeah. didn't get it, or I did get it, I guess. So that loses, I think like 14 to 20 seconds, depending on which bonus game. So
at least the stream will get to see the game, like,
though. Yeah. So this is one of the bonus games you can get. This is like a one-up roulette. Normally you would bet lives, and then I don't really know how it works. I never paid attention. 1 plus 0, so I get 1 life. So I don't know. Pretty annoying. That's the worst of the two bonus games you can get there. The other one just has an exit button that lets you leave immediately. It's pretty nice.
There is a bonus game that's like 40 seconds long, though, that luckily, if you do get a bonus on 5-2, you can't get that one. This is just using fire melons a lot in this level to kind of cheese through stuff.
Yep.
Skip various platforms and bridges.
There's another Baby Mario section coming up here. See how it goes. There's some really neat movement you can get. Alright, it's going good so far. I want to get back to that door before the star runs out. And, oh man, I almost got it. Tried to get a little cape hover above it and I hit the wall.
When Baby Mario actually hits a wall, and he kicks off of it. It's really weird. Don't really use it in speedrunning, but it's interesting. This is that shot that I was talking about. It's one of my favorite tricks. Right here, where you just... Oh, man.
Some people, after they throw the egg, they'll kind of duck after, just in case a spike is left. I don't do that, because that's slow. So some people have some heart attacks in my stream sometimes.
For sure. And sometimes you'll somehow survive things or have some miracle angles work. It's that angle's pretty generous, and I think a lot of different things work. But it's very cool when it does work like that. And not ducking in a marathon, man.
Nah, I mean, that shot is pretty consistent. I wasn't really too worried. Alright, so this skiing section's pretty cute. If you miss any jumps, you kind of would have to kill yourself, but they're pretty generous. And for the second screen here, you don't actually have to do any inputs. Just kind of let Yoshi go on his way.
Go up to the fridge real quick, and like, I mean really, really quick.
Are skis vehicles? That's a good question. I don't know.
I mean, he kind of just goes into a closet and changes.
Yeah.
Skis are more like just scripted segments, I think. That'd be a good way to explain them. I think it's difficult. When I was newer, I'd always miss things on those jumps because, as Trick said, if you miss something, you just have to kill yourself. There's no way to go back and go get it. Ooh, 5-4.
5-4. I don't know. This level, there's not really much to say about 5-4. It's a pretty basic level. I wish there was, like, some kind of cool trick here or something for me to talk about, but, I can't really think of anything. I don't know.
This is, I think, this level has the most amount of time spent in it, like, probably if you take all Yoshi players combined and look at all of their time in any level, this definitely has the most.
Hate that egg shot.
It's very specific, it's weird. So you'll see what I'm talking about with the amount of time spent very soon. Kind of want to keep it hush-hush, or I'm sensing Trix does, so.
I mean, I don't know. I don't know what you're talking about, dude. This level's pretty free. I guess this egg shot can troll you sometimes. I don't know.
It totally can. I don't, It's weird that I can just die there. It's pretty weird. Doing a ground pound during the animation, it cancels after the stairs transform, so that's pretty cool. It's a little bit of swag you can do.
I guess one thing we do is we skip one of the secret rooms again because there's more red coin dupes here.
Yeah. Standard stuff, I'm gonna see. Sometimes you can push that crate not as far, or that little fudge thing not as far and do a perfect flutter. Alright, so this is called 5-4 skip, and tricks, I mean, you can do the honors, my man.
No, I think you can do the honors.
Yeah, never mind, you're focusing. Okay, so. Basically, you'd normally have to take that green moving boo platform throughout this very long section, and it would be an auto-scroller. But if you're really good at this game, you can flutter and jump on bats to skip various things. So right here, you'll see he grabbed the shy guy, and he's going to use that. You see, ups bat it because, as I was talking about earlier, Yoshi will automatically swallow things. He's going to use it to bounce off and gain some height. It's a very difficult trick. Tricks right here makes it look very easy. He's very, very good at it. He's the most consistent I've ever seen anyone be at it. So, he ups bat that, jumped off of it.
Not bad.
There's a lot that goes. Yeah, not bad, dude. This boss is pretty cool because you can just fire 4 shots off screen to kill it. Normally you'd have to keep, you'll see he's this giant slug guy, and he has him like this big heart inside of him. Normally you'd have to keep firing eggs to get to the center of him. And I don't really know how it works, but just firing these eggs off screen at a specific angle works. So it's pretty cool.
Yep, you didn't even really get to see him because of the way the screen scrolled.
Yeah.
But basically how it works is he unloads if you go too far back. So you basically unload him, then throw an egg, and then have him kind of spawn in while the egg is going to be where his heart is. So it just skips having to shoot through the gel at all.
I'm trying to think of what you could compare that to. Maybe that flower shot on 2-6, how the... you shoot the red coins, and then the flower spawns in after when the egg's coming back. A little like that.
Alright, so 5-5 here. Cool. This level doesn't have any Snorice. I think that the theme kind of gets abandoned after 5-4. But, yeah, there's lots of interesting movement there to grab a bunch of eggs from all the birds. There's some ice here, I guess.
I think the idea is that you're, like, going up in the sky more and more, and after 5-4, you've gotten past ground level or something.
Yeah, something like that.
So now you're, like, really high up on a mountain. I don't know, the backgrounds in this game are very, very pretty. I think this might be one of my favorites.
Yeah, it's one of the better ones.
Yeah. There is a way to skip that transformation, but it is, I think, task level, and we won't be seeing that for.
Well, you can skip it at 90%, but it would actually be slower in this category because of all the stuff you have to grab.
Oh, really? Wow.
Yeah. I don't actually know what my star count is. Alright, just grabbed that star cloud to check, because I wasn't paying attention.
Kate Hack. This part's cool, you can kind of do a little bit of swag as you're running up the... I just love vertical sections in this game, I think it's really cool.
Oh man.
Egg shot can be a little weird.
So there, because I had to go for the backup shot there, I also had to spit the thing I had in my mouth so Yoshi didn't automatically swallow it. And I almost got a bonus there, still. That was pretty close.
Yeah.
But we good.
Five, six is, probably... It's a level with maybe some of the most downtime. It's not the most exciting level, but there's a lot of swag you can do because of all of the baddies on the screen.
Yeah, it's the second auto-scroller in this game, or at least full-level auto-scroller. So, kind of boring, but it can be kind of nice to get a little bit of downtime after 5-4 skip. I mean, if that's something you're worried about anyway.
And it is possible, like, unlike other auto-scrollers, it is pretty possible to die on this if you just get hit and get unlucky and go flying down a pit.
Yeah, I've seen that happen before. I think that happened in my first run in this game. If you get hit, basically Yoshi just kind of goes flying to the ground, and if you're above a pit, and that's rip.
The worst is when Yoshi, you haven't gotten hit, so I haven't been able to talk about it. If Yoshi's already hit, and Baby Mario's in the little bubble flying around, and Yoshi gets hit again, he kind of does this little spin, and then either if he's in the air, he just goes flying in a direction, spinning, or he'll lay on the ground for a bit. It wastes a lot of time. You'll lose a lot of stars, and it's very easy to die. These baseball boys also can be pretty mean. They can't actually hurt you, but the eggs can just knock you. It's again a level with a very pretty background, though.
Yeah, pretty nice palette. I wish some more interesting palettes were used in this game. It's interesting. So the ROM hacks of this game kind of show off that a lot of palettes work with some of the textures in this game that aren't really utilized together very well. I mean, the game looks fine, obviously, but it could have been, I don't know, a little nicer looking. Like, there's just, like, kind of mahogany-looking palette that you can use with the wood that never really got used.
You, believe you were doing some ROM hacking. You made 1-1 look like all spooky, and it was really cool. Early, it was like nighttime, and it was all foggy at least.
Well, that was a picture of someone else's hack, but I have made a few levels in this game. I'm gonna need to get a mid-ring, I guess.
Yeah, it's another instance of making red eggs and shooting enemies to skip mid-rings. Normally is what you'd want to do in this level.
Yeah,
since it's an auto-scroller.
What I actually do is, usually I take the mid-ring at the end anyway. Oh man, that Gusty was coming for me. He kind of tongue at the edge of the screen there in case anything spawns like it did. I usually get the smittering anyway, because kind of jumping over those goonies can be pretty annoying sometimes. Well, that was great. And those enemies came down in a super weird way. I'm gonna have to grab another star cloud.
There is one pretty easy backup star cloud in this level, but we're lucky, because the further you get into the game, the harder it gets, I think, at least, to recover with things like extra star clouds in a level.
Yeah, star route gets pretty tight later on, mostly in World 6.
Yeah. lag there can be kind of scary.
So I think that's the longest auto scroller. There is one more, but I don't think it's quite that long.
Yeah, I don't think it is actually, and I think it's this one might be just more entertaining though.
Yeah, probably. So this is the only level in the game where they actually start you off going left instead of right. Gotta kind of pay attention there.
Yeah.
Usually I end up holding right, because that's what I'm used to doing, but you kind of realize once you get in, that's not what you're supposed to do.
And the opposite, if you're grinding this level, practicing, and then going to a normal level, you'll start pressing left. It's also the first level to introduce. Are the, what are the little rafts called?
Let me talk about this egg shack coming up here.
Totally.
All right, I got it. So, this is the only level in the game that has 6 flowers instead of 5. For some reason, there is a flower hidden way up in the sky there. You're not really supposed to be able to get to it, I guess. But if you do a screen scroll and then a very specific egg shot, you can. So it's pretty nice. It skips a long room. That has nothing else but a flower, so it's pretty good.
Pretty sure the devs just kind of moved it, like, didn't take it out of the game is what it was.
Yeah, sure, they just forgot about it. What were you going to say, Mario Man?
Little rafts, the little black birds on the little balls, I guess, or circles. They're introduced in this level, and they're used often when we use them in a speedrun to just jump off of them, give us height. But, I mean, They're pretty cute. I like them. Falling Rocks are terrible. Probably my least favorite part of the game, hands down.
Yeah.
I can explain that if you don't mind, but you can. Because I just have such a hatred for them.
Oh, yeah, no, you can go ahead. You're real passionate about those Falling Rocks.
Okay, so, as we've talked about Perfect Flutter and how...
All right. Well, now you're gonna see what happens if you make a mistake in this game. What I have to do now, I missed a red coin somewhere. I don't know where, but I have to replay this whole level now. I'm just glad it wasn't an auto scroller.
Jeez, yeah. So we've already talked about Perfect Flutters and how when you jump on something and then jump immediately after, they're kind of screwed on the fluttering, right? Well, with Falling Rocks, if you try to do the same thing, not even perfect fluttering, but just trying to jump too soon after you land on it, the input will get eaten, and you won't jump. So you can just think you're jumping, and if it's a little bit of a tight window, you'll run off the rock, and it can be so annoying. It makes me... Oh, man. I do not like Falling Rocks at all.
Yeah, they're pretty annoying. I really don't know where I missed a red coin there.
I think it might have been, that one.
One of those? I thought I saw it get collected.
I thought you fired an egg back and got it, but I guess not.
Dang.
I was thinking either that or the shot. No, because you got the flower in this next room. But, yeah. That's one of the cooler green piranha plant clips, for sure. I like that one a lot. Like, this section right here, we don't even bother jumping until we're running far past the landing point on the platform, because you can just fall down and die.
That was interesting. So you don't want to touch penguins from the side of them, or they push you off.
Talked about that one. Oh, man.
Yeah, World 5 is a good world. And then the rock just ate my jump there. This is going really well.
There's the there's an example of that happening. So I think there's a general consensus, although everyone who plays this game loves it, I hope. I think this world might be one of the least favorite of people who play. It's my least favorite, at least. At least the first half is a lot worse than the second half, but...
Yeah, no, first half is way worse. You got that random bonus game, you got a 5-4 skip, but this section kind of sucks too.
A lot of trickery that goes on. For sure. Oh, man.
Alright, well, that was great.
Replaying the level, yeah. That's what you have to do. 5-8's pretty cool. That off-the-rails trick we were talking about earlier, you'll get to see in this level again. Yellow bullet bills are pretty cool because they, when they hit a wall, they just bounce off of them, and I don't think they really die until they go off screen. Okay, that's an interesting strat, so...
Yeah, if you load in normally, the bullet bill cannon in a weird way, then I gotta do that.
Jeez. Normally you want to bounce off the green bullet bill. Oh man. And how eggs usually die, after 4 or 5 bounces on a wall, they don't on those platforms, which is kind of cool.
Alright, had just enough eggs there to get all those coins, fortunately. Here's the off the rails we were talking about. So, yeah, we got a setup for that, and then kind of clip through the rail here as you go into the tracks, and it lets you skip a huge section of those rails, which fortunately doesn't have any red coins, otherwise we'd still have to go on it. So that saves a good amount of time.
You also skip having to get an additional bubble to not run out of the transformation.
Yeah.
And it luckily ends right when you need it to. It's all very convenient. With some trickery with these little guys here can mess with you.
And then this is kind of a major point of RNG in the run. The boss here will kind of move random directions and randomly decide to attack. So really what you want him to do is you want him to move left at the start of the fight and then never attack. And if you get like really bad RNG, you can lose like 10 seconds or so compared to the best.
This is the coolest boss fight, I think, because of how the game looks, and you get to go upside down and such. It's all very cool.
Yeah, it's pretty neat. It was probably my favorite boss as a kid.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so he went left, that's good. Yeah. And he, decided not to attack there.
Wow.
And we got one attack, so, that was pretty good RNG.
Yeah. Good fight.
Not quite perfect, but it was decent. So, glad to be out of World 5. Kind of wish I didn't have to replay 5-7 there, but it happens on occasion. It's part of why this category is so difficult. Just making a little mistake like that can cost you minutes. It's really easy to slip up and like miss a red coin or forget that you need extra stars or something like that. Or like if you get hit on a boss, like it's basically over. So kind of scary.
World 6, it's pretty cool because it starts off just very fast, and I think it puts all of the skills you've learned to the test pretty well. I can't even speak.
I think I know what you mean, dude.
Yeah. I won't even try to say what I was trying to say there again.
Alright, so yeah, like you said, specifically the first 3 levels of World 6 are super intense. If you're on good pace at this point in the game, you get pretty nervous, because it's really easy to mess up on these levels. But they are pretty cool.
The palettes on all of them are so pretty.
Yeah. This level in particular These jumps are kind of scary when you're first learning the game. And then this has, I would say, the most difficult bonus skip. Sometimes I just kind of fail it, and I don't really know why. It's not as bad as 5-2, which doesn't have a bonus skip, of course, but I would say, like, all the levels that have a bonus skip, this is kind of the worst. So the chomps that come down here are all random. Like, I want the one on the right to jump down right now, but the one on the left jumped down. Now I've got to wait until this guy comes down, and that just lost a little bit of time. Here I don't want a chomp to jump down, but it did, so I gotta wait. Yeah, didn't get very good RNG, but I still got that difficult egg shot, so it's all good.
Yeah, that angle's pretty difficult. There are a few different ways to do it, but your goal is ultimately to get those red coins with an egg before it dies, because it will sometimes die before getting the second angle. And this level, I think, is definitely the one I'll show to someone who wants to know, like, what Yoshi's Island's about, and just, like, what you know, 100% speedrun for the game really consists of. I think it's a very good example just how fast it is. It's a weird bonus skip.
Yeah, this one's kind of like the Z-Wing skip. It's just very, very specific on where you want to jump off of the platform at the end, and then you have to actually spit as soon as you land. And I almost got a bonus there. That was very close. But, you good for now? And then also, 6-3 has probably the second most difficult bonus skip. But, talk about that when we get to it, I guess.
This can be a pretty annoying level, the Cave of Bandits, because those bandits, as we've seen, they don't die when you step on them, but you can tongue through them, so they can just get in the way sometimes and be pretty annoying. Oh, that one looked like it was just, like, scooting across the screen, not running. That was weird.
Yeah, there are weird stuff that can happen in this game. Like, I'm really confused about how that egg went through the wall in 4-7. I'm gonna have to look at that. That was maybe the weirdest thing I've ever seen in this game.
I've had it in 4-6, where I've shot it and gotten that flower at the beginning you normally need to use the shell to get. And it just went through the wall and got the flower. I don't know what happened.
Weird.
That shot's pretty interesting, that neutral as you're falling off the platform has a... How many frame window?
It's just a few frames.
It's pretty tight to get that flower, so you can just keep going fast and jump right above it and get it. It's a Baby Mario transformation. As I said, you can run on spikes, so it's pretty cool. Cut it close at the end here. We skip one of the stars intentionally, so he'll Yoshi will bounce on one of the baseball boys before going near the goal ring. But you just gotta be careful to, so you're in the air when it runs out, because if you're on the spikes when it runs out, you're screwed.
Yep, and went pretty well. Didn't get the bonus, which is great. I actually didn't get that flower intentionally. People always ask me if it was intentional or not when I flutter back for that flower. That's actually how the bonus skip works. That's the visual cue for when you want to start fluttering back. So, it is intentional.
If you accidentally get it, you can just go to the first spike, but that doesn't necessarily work. So that's by far the most consistent method. This level is pretty interesting because it introduces... I think it's the only point in the game that has these spinning platforms that boost you up when you get hit by them, and you get the high flutter as if you bounced off an enemy after being boosted up. It's pretty cool.
And then Fuzzies also make a return, and just to tell you how they can kill you in 4-1, they can do the same thing here if you're on one of those mushrooms. You can just clip right through the floor. Really annoying. Here I'm going to do another mid-ring skip, where the game doesn't pause because I opened a cloud while I went through the mid-ring.
Plus it gives you 27, so normally on this screen if you got hit at 25 you'd be screwed, so this gives you a little bit of room for error.
And the bonus skip there, like we said earlier, for zooming. So the reason I messed that up is because for zooming skips, you want to be moving at full speed.
Mm-hmm. I know what you did.
And then it's kind of hard. You have to wait until the log is moving flat, so it's just really hard to like set that all up well. Trying to land the log. All right, so this is good at least. In World 6, you will. Oh man, there we go. Triple melons.
All right. Nice.
That's what I wanted. So yeah, but like I was saying, in World 6, you'll either get the shortest bonus game or the longest one. So the shortest one you can get is slots, and that's great because that's what I just got. But then the longest one you can get is match cards, where you have to. The game will like show you all these cards, and then it'll like flip them over, and then you have to try to match them. And there's no way to just leave it. You have to fail it twice until it lets you leave. So it loses 29 seconds. It's really unfortunate.
It's a bit like matching in Mario 3, I think.
Yeah.
I think what made you get the bonus there was you bounced off of the. I don't usually bounce off of the turtle or the Koopa, but I don't know if that had to do with it made you like faster or something.
Yeah, it could have. I think that's what I usually do, but maybe that's why I sometimes mess it up.
This salvo is, I guess what I was talking about back in World 1, how the angles in this game are different, and it's just like, or so unique that it's kind of cool that we've come far away, and that there are so many unique angles that are just developed for certain fights and routes that, like the other salvo was a few horizontal and then a vertical shot, and then this one was just all vertical. Pretty cool stuff. It's actually pretty specific to set that up, though, in this level.
Mm-hmm. So this part of the stage, you have to go in all these different pipes to get the collectibles. It's probably the least interesting part of the stage. There's only like three pipes you have to go into, and some of the egg shots are kind of cool, but the pipe transitions take a little too long for me to really enjoy it.
Looks cool though. I mean, you don't usually get to see Mario pipes. Or in this game, at least, above ground, so. We're also going to do a skip to, get around that little pipe with the keyhole that normally you need a key to get through.
Yeah, normally in this level you actually have to fight Salvo twice, and then he gives you a key both times, but you can just do, pretty specific perfect flutter to get over the wall instead.
I actually didn't know it was a perfect flutter.
Yeah, it's a perfect reflutter.
I don't know how I do it so often then.
Dang. It's there's different kinds of perfect flutters. So the first reflutter you do after a normal flutter is actually a much bigger window than most perfect reflutters.
Okay, that makes sense actually.
Yeah, it's pretty strange.
So coming up is lava skip, and I'll explain that since Trix will probably be busy trying not to lose any height here. He's just constantly doing an extended flutter or a reflutter similar, or an extended flutter or perfect flutter similar to 5-4 skip in order to skip what would be normally a very boring and long auto-scroller.
Yeah, taking the log can be kind of bad. The log actually, if you do it well, only loses like 3 seconds, but it's really hard to do it well. I find it easier to just flutter over the lava, honestly.
Just go for that. This is a return of the breaking blocks, which is pretty cool, and you need only just 4 eggs to do this whole boss fight. It's very cool.
Yep, pretty neat.
4 neutrals. Once again, neutrals coming into play and just being very useful.
And then it's always a huge relief to be done with that segment if you're on a good run, because the second half of World 6 is definitely easier than the first half.
Yeah.
So, coming up here, 6-5, this is the last auto-scroller in the game. It's got, like, lava and stuff. It's, like, kind of fire and ice themed, I guess. There's, like, icicles from the ceiling, lava on the ground.
think it might be the most nerve-wracking auto-scroller because there's a jump that can be, it's possible to mess up. It's not too hard, but, you can mess it up, and also lava, of course, kills you in one hit, so. I've never seen a ghost guy go like that.
Oh, yeah, so that's kind of weird. If there aren't really a whole lot of version differences in this game. Really nothing that really matters if you want to run it. You don't have to like hunt down a specific version or anything. But for some reason, in the 1.0 version of the game, if you grab one of these ghost guys as they come out of the pipe and then spit them, they just have really weird physics, and they'll like pass through walls and kind of float in the air, depending on how you spit them. I don't even know like why they fixed that glitch and not like some major glitches in the later versions. It's pretty weird.
Kept things like gate hack, but
yeah, I guess that's all they found.
Doesn't even seem like a glitch to me. It seems like something that'd be just put in because they're ghosts.
Yeah, I know. Like it doesn't even seem that weird.
So, I mean, there's some minor swag you can do in this level, but, I think less so than other auto-scrollers. Just focusing on, once again, making red eggs so you skip the middle ring, so you don't have to waste time.
So the level actually kind of scrolls around the same area you went through earlier at this point, which is pretty interesting. I don't know if they like intended you to really notice, but yeah, if the level wasn't an auto scroller, you could kind of just come down this path immediately, and it would be super short. Too bad that isn't the case.
It's almost like a giant maze and you're just being directed by the camera. It's kind of cool. But I learned that it was not actually a huge thing, it was more of a little contained area. It's kind of crazy to hear.
So, this is the second half of the auto-scroller. Not quite as long as the first. I don't think there's like any lava or anything. I guess there are pits you could fall into. And there's like a bunch of hidden star clouds.
Not as much risk. That jump I was going to talk about, the jump with that boulder there. It's I've seen other people lose runs to just falling off that boulder because you need to walk in the other direction the boulder's going, and Yoshi can just kind of slide off and into the lava. There are a few safety strats, like carrying a shy guy all the way to that point, which I'm personally a fan of that. I like it.
Yeah, well, that actually saves time. I just accidentally killed the shy guy earlier, so I had to use the rock the way it was intended.
That might be actually one of the hardest tricks they put in the game, like, for intentional use.
Yeah, probably. It's kind of annoying, like, level at the end of the auto-scroller, too. That would be so
doesn't
dumb.
Doesn't this
casually
level have two exits, like 4-3?
No, it's the same exit either way. It's just you don't go through this part of the auto-scroller if you're playing
right.
80%.
That's it, okay. You can't, well, it's another instance of not being able to get 100% if you don't go through a certain route.
Yeah, and this is actually supposed to be another auto-scrolling room, but if you can get a perfect jump like I did there, the screen doesn't scroll up, and then it never actually loads the auto-scroll sugar, so you can just run through this part pretty nice.
That's because it doesn't detect him on the ground, so there's no reason for the game to think It's time to start the auto-scroller. Spawn and skip is pretty cool. You just need Yoshi's body, like, half on this little, pole. And then you just run forward and do an upshot. So, it'd be pretty cool.
Mm-hmm. One of the easier ones.
Coming up is a level kind of like... I'd compare this to 2-2 a little bit. It's like a giant kind of maze with a lot of different areas. Maybe even 4-4. I don't know.
Yeah,
6-6 is very cool, though.
It's supposed to be this huge maze. A big chunk of the maze, actually, doesn't have anything in it, so we can skip going through it, even though there is a key that you're supposed to get in it. So, gonna have to do Perfect Flutter to get up here, ground pound the crate, get all these stars and coins. And then, normally you're supposed to push this Chomp Rock to the right and use it to get through the maze, but you can actually push it to the left. And then if you position it correctly... Alright, that should be good. And then do the right inputs. And that's actually one pixel off.
Yeah.
There you go. You can actually just pull the key right through the wall, and that saves a ton of time.
There's a method to skip the rock completely. Saves about 8 seconds, but you put yourself at risk for tonguing the key incorrectly and not being able to get it at all unless you go through the intended method, because it will fly far away to where Yoshi won't even be able to get it. So oftentimes when you're on good pace or something, it's not even worth it to try.
Yeah, well, I abandoned that strat entirely. The strat to not use the rock is actually double frame perfect and speed dependent, and this game runs at 60 FPS, so double frame perfect is... I don't really think it's even reasonable to go for. Some people don't agree with me, and they go for it in runs. But last time I tried that in a marathon run, I lost like 30 seconds or something to it, and it was pretty embarrassing. So I'm pretty much done never going for that again.
I think it's definitely a meme at this point for a lot of people.
Yeah.
Whether there's a big debate on whether you should do this little trick or not.
It's pretty funny.
There's a lot of different star routes in this level. Everyone kind of does their own thing. But it's overall, I think, a really, really cool level, how it's designed.
So here, I'm going to do kind of an interesting skip. I'm going to use this toady, I'm going to spit it right there, and then get a flutter off of it and skip shooting this cloud that would make a platform appear normally. Saves a good amount of time.
It's kind of like 2-2 for that as well, I guess.
Yep, and then here you just kind of duck at the right spot and then run to the goal for the bonus skip.
It's an interesting visual cue.
Yeah, you can talk about that visual cue if you want.
Alright.
If you want to be responsible for this.
I didn't. So, there's a little cutout on the wall behind Yoshi. There's a few various cutouts in the rocks. And your goal, as I think Trihex might have been the person to start this, was to go until one of the cutouts looked like a little wiener.
Yeah.
So
it's courtesy of Trihex. Now none of us can unsee it. So thanks, buddy.
It works, man. This level's kind of interesting. There's like a camera scroll you can do, so you don't have to wait for that platform to spin around for Yoshi to jump on it, but... it's pretty difficult to do, and it's not really worth it.
Did I miss a coin there? I'm pretty sure there's only two coins.
Yeah, there's only two coins.
Okay. I always forget.
These platforms are similar to falling rocks. My hatred isn't quite as strong, but jumping on them can be a little weird because they have to be pressed down. I haven't quite determined if they're the same as falling rocks, and if you have to wait a second before jumping off of them, but they're just a little funky. You'll often buffer a flutter off of them, which is Yoshi will run off the platform and start fluttering because the game thinks you're holding down B, or I guess you would be in this case, but for a different reason.
Oh boy.
Oh boy.
Yeah, so that was kind of interesting. Here's what I'm looking for. So, yeah, got hit at a weird spot, had to egg Baby Mario back down. Glad I could tell where he was at, or that could have been way worse.
Also, I mean, it's to show the viewers that egging Baby Mario brings him down.
Yeah, I guess it does.
I'm a big fan of egging Baby
Mario. It's popping milk.
I'm a big fan of this level because it's a lot of really, I guess it's anticipation for 6-8. And you're like, I don't know, when I play through it, I'm thinking the whole time, like, oh man, 6-8's next. And it's 6-8's just a hype level. It's really cool, in my opinion.
Well, it's got an auto scroller, so I don't know if I agree with that. But it's got some cool
boss
stuff,
fight's
I guess.
Awesome.
Alright, so there earlier, made a whole bunch of stars off of the tap-tap, and that's just so I spend less time getting stars from the middle ring.
Yep. It's actually possible to do a skip there with that gas mask, or what are they called, those Shy Guys? Snippets?
Yeah.
It's possible to do a skip where you bounce off one of those and you skip the mid-ring and waiting for that platform, but it's pretty difficult. I think this area might be a reason why this level's a little hype to me. It's because you get to see, like, Bowser's castle in the background.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. The bonus skip here is pretty annoying, though. The only consistent one is to flutter and then ground pound to do another flutter. So, it looks super slow, and it is super slow, but it's the only way to consistently not get a bonus.
That gate hack's interesting because it has to do with that little, cactus with, Was it the sprite IDs and how they load in?
Yeah,
depending on how everything loads in.
I have no idea why it's depending on sprite IDs, but you have to load all the enemies in that second to last room there in a very specific way to spit the enemy to make it open up the gate. And then we got another helicopter here. I still don't know why you like this level so much. I mean, it's got a helicopter, it's got an auto-scroller. I don't know.
Maybe it's because of one speedrunner in the community. His name is The Round Cube. He's known. He's spent countless hours on this level getting the IL world record. His is pretty darn good.
It is an expert pretty good. I guess I'm glad that someone made there be a good IL world record here, but man, I can't imagine, like, actually doing that.
Yeah.
You have to, like, sit through an auto-scroller coming up and then, like, get a perfect Bowser fight, which is insane to do. Can't imagine.
I'll explain that door just now. So that door has a pretty consistent setup. Basically, there are four spinning doors there, and they all offer the same amount of flowers and red coins inside. And it's just, it doesn't really matter which one you were to take casually, but if you're speedrunning, the fastest one is door four because you just run straight ahead and get everything. So this room is, as we've done with almost every single auto-scroller, trying to use red eggs on enemies to make stars. And there's a little bit of RNG here because the Shy Guy is the only creature Kamek can spawn that you can make stars off of. You can't do it off bats or milts. So.
Yeah, but if you're good enough, you only have to get one Shy Guy because you can kind of tongue them after they get hit by an egg so they don't die. So it's usually not too bad. He can also spawn stars from these blocks, so you could just get really good RNG with that, I guess.
I think there are worse auto-scrollers. You're pretty preoccupied during this one to get those stars and at the same time dodge all of Kamek's spells and make eggs and pretty busy, so.
Mm-hmm.
Trying not to fall through the floor from an off-screen spell as I've done. And do a perfect flutter to get up there. You know, now it doesn't even matter if you were to take the save ring, because once you enter the big red door, the game saves. So if you were to die on the Bowser fight, you'd still be in the room. So if you have 30 stars, there's no reason to take it even for backup.
Yeah, it's pretty nice how they did that. Although it's kind of weird, because they also put a save ring there. I don't know why they did both. I guess for stars?
Stars, yeah. For casuals trying 100%.
Alright, so got the baby Bowser fight here. This fight's pretty easy. Just gotta kind of ground pound on the floor, send these ripples through the ground as baby Bowser is about to jump on it.
Pretty important mechanic in this fight at the end here.
Yeah. You basically have to reset if you don't get it. Sure, I'm glad I got that.
Rated E for everyone, dude.
Rated E for everyone. Alright, and then here's the actual boss fight.
It's very cool.
Yeah, it's probably the coolest fight in the game, and definitely the most difficult. Bowser kind of shows up in the background here, and you have to throw eggs at him in the background, and it's just very, very difficult to aim specifically enough. Yeah, we'll see how many shots I miss here. I'm kind of notorious for missing tons of shots, honestly.
People often use the colors of the sky in the background. You see the different shades of purple and orange in the line, the cursor with a certain one, a certain color, to get the correct shot. I don't personally do that. I just go for what I think feels right, and that tends to work. But sometimes if you miss one and get kind of off from what you think feels right, you can mess up a lot more. So.
Yeah, and super annoying there. Let me actually try to get the shot first. Fuck. Alright, I think that might be it. I don't know. This shot is the most specific. Yeah, it's pixel perfect, so I'm glad I got it there. Wasn't really sure if I was going to. That one might be aimed a little high. We'll see. Are we good?
Dang, dude. Nice.
I was a little too far away there. And that one was not
a little
great.
Low, yeah.
Alright, well, not a bad fight. As soon as he starts exploding, you actually have to reset the game, because once the credits are done playing out, they actually there's no way to get back to the level select without resetting, so we just do it as soon as the game saves that level.
Normally, resetting would save time in any instance after beating a world to skip the cutscene, but that's not allowed in the category, and as Trick said, the only reason why we do it is because that's the soonest point it saves, and you cannot
it's
continue if you
weird.
Don't reset. So, kind of have to, so.
Oh my god.
Oops.
It's kind of weird that we don't allow reset, seeing as you have to do one at one point. I don't know why or how that started.
This is this level is also one of the very few version differences between regions. Yoshi's name in Japanese is Yasi, so in this level normally it would spell out Yoshi on the platform section coming up, but instead it says Yasi, so it's kind of cool. Doesn't waste any time to my knowledge.
Unless you do that.
Ooh, boy.
Yeah, that's why I'm glad we take the mid-ring right before this room. That can be kind of tricky. Oh well, not too worried
about
that.
Hitboxes on spikes are weird. I think the hurtboxes are. The hitbox is like very, very close to the sprite, but then to break it.
Oh my god! Spaghetti! It's fine, I got one life left. Let's just not die again, hopefully.
You have to press the jump button very, very lightly when you're going up like that, because Yoshi just flies like crazy. Even if it's barely going up, for example, on that on this O here, when you jump, it doesn't seem like the platform's going fast, but Yoshi will still jump at a very high height.
Hmm.
Star RNG can be kind of screwy there, so.
Alright. That was interesting. Nothing I can wait for that platform to come down. Like a,
yeah, nothing makes a hundo run like a nice hot plate of spaghetti, so. He's, Trix is currently getting red eggs in this part because it's interesting. Normally, for extras, it would make sense to just do them all in order. But getting the red eggs here, he does it, because he goes immediately to 4E. And in 4E, the star route's, little interesting. I think it wastes a lot more time if you don't have red eggs going into it. So, makes the level quicker. It's a long level, too.
Yeah. 4E is one of the longer extra levels. I don't think we even really explained extra levels, so basically, if you get 100% on a world, you unlock an extra level for that world, and for this category, we have to actually get 100% on those extra levels as well.
This is a similar bonus skip to 4-7, where you can just jump off of the platform, or not even jump, but the platform sets you at a speed higher than Yoshi's top speed, and you can just run into the goal.
Pretty nice. There aren't really any scary bonus skips for extras, fortunately. There was one that was kind of weird for a while, but we finally found a way to kind of make it consistent.
You're talking about 2E?
Yeah, 2E. Yeah.
It's a little weird.
So like Martin said, it's gonna go right to 4E rather than going to 5E, even though it loses time on menuing. It's definitely faster to carry in all these red eggs. And then also, what I'm going to try to go for is, as I go through these doors, I'm going to be jumping, trying to kind of jump on the same frame that I go through the door on, and then that's just like the same idea as pipe glitches. It skips the animation as you go through, like there's the animation right there because I missed it.
Stars can be a serious problem in this level, so those red eggs are important, and if you get hit, there's a few backups. You can use one of the crates to get stars, but that involves going in the door and out the door an extra time, so.
Yeah, it's like backup only, really.
And this is a long level, even, with speedrunning strats. If you played this casually, I remember as a kid, it takes a very, very long time. Especially if you want 100% it. And this level will see the return of flashing red eggs, which we haven't seen since... Have we not seen them since 1-7?
No,
No, think... no.
I think they're somewhere else, right? I don't know, actually.
Jeez, I think
somewhere. It might have been since 1-7. You're right.
Yeah, I think so. So, in this level, I think it's just convenient to take them to the goal ring, because when you take a red egg to the goal ring, it'll just turn into the red coin. So you don't need to worry about collecting them or positioning yourself or losing the coin, whiffing the egg. Yeah, now that I think about it, I legitimately think it's 1-7. Kind of crazy.
Yeah, I thought they were used more than that.
And, red eggs are... Flashing red eggs are pretty cool because they flash... Trix, you like this. You like to talk about this. Do you want to talk about it?
Oh, yeah, sure. So, the flashing red eggs, every frame, they change color. They start off as green, and then they move to... they switch to yellow, and then red. And then on the fourth frame, they actually switch to purple, which isn't even a color of egg you can normally get. So, I think that's kind of neat.
And if you break them on an enemy or something, on the purple egg frame, the shell pieces will be purple, so it's really cool.
Yeah, makes you wonder if they're maybe planning on having purple eggs in the game. At some point, I don't know what they would even do.
Yeah. I think 5E was probably... I think it's probably the hardest level to play through casually. because it involves skiing again, and if you mess up, you'd have to kill yourself, and there's a pretty easy mess up, even speedrunning. At least it took me a while to learn everything and all the visual cues. Not to mention Kamek flying around everywhere. Oof. That little jump on the bird.
Yeah, so 5E, I guess it's snow themed since World 5 is the snow world. For the most part, all the extra levels are kind of themed after whatever world they're from. So I would say this is the second hardest extra level. Depending on what extras route you do, some people will actually do what's called early extras, which is where you lose 2 seconds, but you get three super hard levels out of the way about halfway through the run, where you do like the first three extras after World 3. Since I play at a pretty high level, world record level, I do just late extras, where I do all of them at the end because it saves 2 seconds. But it definitely makes sense if you want to get if you want to do early extras, because the upcoming extra level right after this one is pretty scary.
Yeah. We'll talk about that when we get to it, but I also think it's ultimately up to personal preference, and really, a lot of this game is mental, I think. There's, of course, a lot of physical skill involved, but mindset is very important. So if you're in the mindset like, man, I just want to keep going, I think it's a lot better to just do all of the...
Yeah, I wasn't gonna risk Kamek.
Do all the worlds first, because you kind of get going in a little bit of a rhythm. That's why I personally save all the extras for last, and I'm not really at a high level.
Yeah, it's kind of nice to just do them all at the end, I think. Because,
yeah,
you know, like you said, you get in the mindset for, alright, these are the hardest levels.
Yeah,
not really the hardest, but they're pretty rough.
Yeah, just kind of like the finishing levels where, like, you go from 3 to 4 and just flows more seamlessly.
So, infamous level 3E, Freezy Peasy. tons of dumb stuff can happen in this level. This level has way too many sprites. I kind of think it's poorly designed. So, like I said earlier, if there are too many sprites on the screen, rather than lagging, the game will try to despawn sprites, and it'll even despawn collectibles. So, what happens in this level, because there's so many monkeys that spit so many seeds, it's kind of ridiculous. If you don't hit them in time, alright, looks like I got it there, you can despawn a whole bunch of red coins there and have to flutter off screen, then come back on, and it's just a huge mess. And if you get hit anywhere, there's nowhere that you can quickly make your stars back, so that's a huge pain as well.
You might as well just restart the level if you get hit.
Yeah, basically. The only good thing about this level is that it's pretty short, so it's over quickly as long as you don't mess up.
It's a pretty good 3. Also, another thing is, in this game, when you beat a level, you can start select out of it, and normally that's fine for practicing, but extra levels actually are convenient that you can do it even if you haven't beaten the level yet. So if you mess up on 3E or you know you're screwed, instead of wasting time killing yourself, just pause it and then press select to come back to the map screen and restart it.
Yeah, it's kind of some saving grace, I guess, for extras.
We hope it doesn't happen though.
Alright, so 2E, there's nothing really too difficult about this level, but if you do make a mistake, like if your screen scrolling is bad here, at this point, then you won't load in the top red coin there, and then even if you pass through it, it's not loaded in, so you just won't get it. And then that next shot was kind of dumb. And I actually had to jump on that switch at the end because I wasn't going to make it.
I was hoping you would do that.
And now I gotta wait out this Switch. Ugh.
The Nintendo Switch, this is what they're coming out with.
Alright, and then the bonus skip there, you just ground pound in front of the last red coin. And missed the bonus skip, apparently. I don't know what I did wrong there.
So weird.
That is kinda weird, I'll have to look into that. unfortunately, the bonus games don't take up that much time in World 2. They've got some of the shorter bonus games. Oh, and we're lucky, it's slats again. So this is the shortest one.
Can you get, World 2, can you get the mystery item one, right?
Yeah, that's the other one.
With the shades?
It's got, like, these window shades that you open up and reveal an item behind.
You could do that and, get, like, a plus 20 and use it in, 1E, which would actually I don't know if it would save time. It would be less bad, though, than getting any other bonus and item from the bonus. So sometimes bonuses, although terrible, can be somewhat forgiving if you're lucky.
So final level here, 1E. The reason I'm fluttering all the way up here is because this level is actually supposed to be an auto scroller.
Oh. Those bats.
Yeah, those are some interesting bats. Oh man. If you go too much onto the wrong part of the screen, you'll still trigger the auto scroller. But otherwise, you just gotta kind of flutter all the way up and avoid it, and then you can just run on through the level at your own pace.
I think this level is actually harder when it's an auto scroller too. So.
Yeah, probably. Where's Poochie? Oh, hey there.
And the level's called Poochie Ain't Stupid, but I think a lot of speedrunners agree he can be at times.
It's the biggest lie Nintendo's ever told.
Yeah.
Alright, and that's it. Time is coming up at the map screen when the little card that says 100 on it flips over. So, I'll just make sure I got 100.
Actually, it's impossible to get a bonus on that stage, by the way. Just a side note.
Yeah, I don't know why, but they just kind of made it impossible. Alright, so I'll say it when it's time. Time.
2:35:55
nice,
might have been a 54.
All right. Yeah. Not bad. I had to replay a level, so I'm actually really surprised that that's as low of a time as it is.
Not bad.
Yeah, it was pretty good. Got a lot of bonuses too. But thanks for having us, Milk. Nice marathon.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun.
Is there anything you'd like to say as the last marathon, or the last run of the marathon?
Is there anything I'd like to say as the last run of the marathon?
Is this the last run of the Martin?
This is DJ Dash.
That was
DJ
Dash.
DJ
Dash
is over. Well, man, Turks, it's crazy, dude. Seems like it went really well. I was really impressed with this marathon, honestly. Thanks for watching, guys.
A lot better than the last marathon, for sure. I'm glad to see a nice speedrunning marathon coming up that's not terrible.
Not terrible.
Yeah. You know, my boy Pal Mill here works hard. God bless him.
Gosh bless. And gosh bless America.
Yeah, thank you guys for watching.
Yeah, thanks for watching this run in Legion Dash. And I guess I'll host somebody or something.
That's actually a good finale run.